Very good morning, friends, and welcome to today's market commentary. So on the higher time frame chart, Nifty took a clear support from this trend line support, even though yesterday results were not in favor of the ruling government. But still, it made a support. It took a support near this long-term trend line support, and then it bounced back from that level. Let us open that option chain also on side. So here we'll jump to daily frame time frame and see. So even RSI also did not go below the 40 level. So at 42.6, it took a clear support there, and then from that level it bounced back. So the level where Nifty took a support. Yeah, good morning, friends. I think we have lost the connection, so I'll start it from again. So we were looking at the monthly time frame, and on monthly time frame we drew our trend line support earlier, and even yesterday also Nifty took a clear support at that trend line support. And on daily time frame, if we see, RSI did not go below the 40 level. So that's also a good sign. Now, whatever the resistance was there on Nifty in form of gap down, that is also broken today. Let me mark that level. So this is the area of gap. The zone is the gap zone. We had a higher gap down. Now today that gap is also taken out by a gap up from Nifty. So overall things now turn out to be bullish, because Nifty, whatever the downfall it had to make, it seems to have taken already. This is also a bullish engulfing candlestick pattern. At this point, what we need to check is put option OI. At what price there was a highest put option OI? Even as of now, we have 10,000. Is bearing the highest put option OI, so that still stands out to be a good support. And second highest lies at 10,200. So somehow Nifty has taken its support here. So it is only because of the monthly trend line support. On daily, we don't have any support level at this price zone. Even on Nifty's option chain, if we see, the highest OI lies at 10,000 only, so which is far below that. That was somewhere around here. And similarly, Bank Nifty also, if we see, so Bank Nifty, the great amount of support was around 25,410, and above that 25,929 was the support. So this range is the great amount of support for Bank Nifty. So both Nifty and Bank Nifty, they did not come down to the strong support levels. They jumped up in between only. So however, what we thought, that Nifty or Bank Nifty might not go down below the support levels, because they have already discounted the factor that the ruling government is not going to win the most of the states. So Nifty and Bank Nifty, both of them have taken the support and jumping up now. Now we'll jump to the stocks for the day. So first is Glenmark Pharma. Glenmark Pharma is bullish above 668. So these two candles have a similar high, which is around 668. So if candle closes above that, then our first target for the same should be 685. And then based on the previous highs, you can trail your stop loss. Godrej Industries. So Godrej Industries, it is in bullish zone as of now, and it has a very strong resistance near 555. So if we have a good close above 555, we can see a very big up move in Godrej Industries. Even Havells India, a small trendline resistance is visible here. So above this trendline resistance, Havells is bullish. This is not a perfect trade, and this can be a very risky. So this is just for educational purpose. Then we have Hexaware, and even this is also facing resistance here at 335. So above 335, this can be quite bullish. And the immediate resistance the stock might face is around 351. And above 351, it is further bullish. So Kaveri Seeds, it is bullish above 545. Above 545, the stock can be very bullish on the upside. So small trend and trendline resistance here and a horizontal resistance at 545. So this is the trendline resistance in PVR. So above this trendline resistance, PVR is bullish. And this is the trendline resistance in RAMCOCEM. Above this trendline resistance, we can search for bullish opportunities. Similarly, in TCS, 2020 is the resistance level. Above 2020, we need to search for bullish opportunities. And the immediate resistance for the same for this stock would be 2042. So if this stock can cross 2042, then we can keep this 2276, which is the previous high, as our target. Meanwhile, even RSI will also come up if this resistance is broken. Even in UPL, these three candles share a similar high. First one, second one, and third one. So about 1240, you can start looking for bullish opportunities. UPL, So UPL, a trend line resistance and a trend line support. Above this, the stock was bullish, and in intraday, it has already given 2%. Now, a positional trade, one can keep 790 as their target. Next is Voltas. Trendline resistance here. Above this trendline resistance, we can be bullish in Voltas. McDowell, there's already a breakout happening here below the resistance level, below the support level. But now it is not clear actually. We need to see whether it will sustain below this support or not. Page Industries, there are two bullish divergences. First is this. And the second one is this one. This low to this low and this low to this low. So these two lows are almost similar, so that we cannot consider it as a bullish divergence. Now let us start from the monthly time frame. Do we have any long-term support at that price level? At this current price level, we do not have support on monthly time frame. So these two are the supports on the weekly time frame. 25,500 and 22,800. So if bullish divergence happens at any of these two zones, we would have had a good confidence in taking up a bullish trade. Let us see on daily time frame also. Yeah, even on daily time frame, it suggests the same actually. So if we had a bullish divergence at 22,800 or even at 25,400, then that would definitely be a very good U-turn in favor of bullishness. As of now, I don't have confidence in saying to take up this trade. Yeah, even pivot points also suggest the same. At least at this S2, if we have the divergence, then we could have taken the trade. Yeah, we will wait and see if price comes down to this support zone. I'm facing connectivity issues today. ICICI Bank, No particular pattern as of now. Yeah, that's it for today. These were the stocks and indices. Thank you all for joining.